other members of our parish family, our first communicants, today you receive a very special gift. The first time you receive Jesus as he offers himself to us as food, give us strength to our minds, to our bodies, and to our spirit. It's a gift of great love. That we might grow into the fullness of that love, we just take a moment to reflect on how well we have been open to love, and how well we have loved others. Perhaps the times we've not loved as we should, we course, the ministry and the kingdom, especially if it concerns God, would be something very, very complicated. But I would offer to you, maybe you don't know this person, but I'm sure your parents or grandparents do, Leonard Bernstein, conductor of the New York Philharmonic Orchestra. Very talented man, very much a man who was devoted to teaching music and the love of music to children, as well as to all people. But he had a great production in honor of President Kennedy. And in that production called The Mass, he had a great song and a very honorable
God said to Solomon,
what a great answer, Solomon. You didn't ask anything for yourself. You weren't selfish in any way, shape, or form. But you asked for something that you could help other people to become better as a king. You asked to know what is right and what is wrong. Solomon, I will give you that and more. And you will be known as a very, very, very wise person. Because when we receive the Eucharist, we're doing it at the Mass. That is that reminder to us of Jesus' Last Supper, of Jesus upon the cross, and of Jesus resurrected. And isn't Jesus at that supper the one who says to his disciples, I want to wash your feet? Because it's about service as a sign of love. It's about humbling yourself so that you might know that you are that important. Mom and Dad, every time you go out to work, every time you tread over your child if they're sick or if they're struggling, isn't that a sign of your love? And when the younger members of the family, when you see your moms and dads working for you and helping you out, don't you see that a sign of his love? A sign that they're serving you? Even when they tell you to go to bed early and turn off the computer, or they kind of ground you for a while, or they say you can't do something, and you get real angry and annoyed, isn't that them serving you? They stop to think about it because they don't want you to get hurt. They see something that they realize that you don't get. Maybe if you continue doing what you're doing, you're going to end up in trouble. They're trying to prevent you from getting into trouble, from getting hurt. Because we learn in order to leave, in order to serve. Jesus said that to his disciples. I share my body, I share my blood with you. And when he rose, he told them, now it's your time to go out and to serve the world. Give witness to all the things I said about the Father. This is what you have to do. So, if we are people, as we've been told, or as the school might say, for the teaching, what really matters is not success, but compassion and the helping of others. And if we were told as we went to school that we should listen to our teachers, the question is now, do we listen to Jesus? Whose voice are we listening to in our world that has so many voices coming at us? Who's the voice that we say we will follow? The voice of Jesus ultimately is the treasure, the pearl, that one should be willing to give everything up to have that one possession. And if you listen to that at times, you kind of say, how odd is that? Somebody would sell everything to get one little pearl. Maybe he lives up on Strong's Neck or Oldfield, and they got this, a couple of acres of this beautiful house with a built-in pool, and they have a tennis court, and blah, 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 blah. Why would they give all that up for one little pearl? Because they see a beauty in that that's worth everything. Or if you're a coin collector, you take a couple of coins that are so-so, but you trade them all in for one coin that you know has more value. My day is trading baseball cards. So you can get the card we needed to complete, whereas we knew it had more value, whatever it might be. Just wonder how often we might have heard, I'd sell my soul to get that, to have such and such. We say the same about the kingdom. Would we do the same about the kingdom? Again, the voices we hear, we listen on, onto the news, the TV, or the radio, or read the papers, Democrat, Republican, pro-life, women's rights, undocumented, illegal, white privilege, repression, Black Lives Matter, All Lives Matter, pro-police, anti-police, on and on and on and on and on. What voice? Whose voice? What agenda? Whose agenda do we follow? The worlds can be one of violence, division, and revenge. Jesus, love one another as I have loved you. So let me bring it back to today. Because it is a very simple thing. God is the simplest of all. Love. And for our first communicants, today is a day that you have discovered in your heart, or maybe rediscovered in your heart, the gift of the treasure of God's love and his kingdom. And you have a heart that is filled with gratitude and humility and awe for all that God has created. When you receive the gift of Holy Communion, the Eucharist, what you are saying and doing
we're just going to ask the first communicants, if you would please come up around the front. So, I said 7 or 8 years ago, Mom and Dad worship to a baptism font, maybe this or one, or something like this. And they were asked questions by the priest and the deacon. They're willing to commit themselves in their faith, what they really believe. And as you're coming to the table of Jesus, okay, because you were baptized, that's where it begins. That's when you become part of his family. And like in your family, Mom and Dad say, come to the table, right? But you've got to be strong. You've got to feed you, you've got to nourish, right? And like you've done, I'm sure, with schoolmates, you say, come to my house for cookies or milk or something, ice cream, s'mores, whatever it may be. Just because you want to share yourself with your friend, Jesus is saying to you, come, come. But because it is something special, Sister Carlo, who's the head of our faith formation, okay, is kind of like a parent that wants to make sure that you all know that command of love. So she's going to ask you these questions that your parents answered for you 7 or 8 years ago, and you're going to say, if you can, yes, I believe you. Okay?
Do you believe in God? Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Yes, I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by the water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life.
Amen. Now, part of that baptism at the time, and something that we can't do nowadays, so our holy water is hand sanitizer, means that you were blessed. So Mrs. DeCarlo is going to take this water which came from the tap, okay, so it's clean water, and she's just going to make the sign of the cross on your forehead as a sign of your baptism, okay, and that the light is within you. And then when you are assigned, you can go back to your parents. Moms and dads, godparents and grandparents, this day is a great statement of your fulfillment of the promise to the church. It still goes on, but just to let you know that we are very appreciative of the example that you have made for your sons and daughters, and that today we hope you share and enjoy what you see before you, and that they will have in receiving Holy Communion. We just give moms and dads a round of applause. Sacraments of his unending love in the world. Let us pause to embrace in prayer the Lord that he came to save.
Our response will be, Lord, receive our prayer. That the communion we share remind every follower of Christ that we are baptized for service and fed to become one. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, receive our prayer.
That our children celebrating their first communion experience the love of God through the witness of our Eucharistic community. Let us pray for the Lord.
Lord, receive our prayer.
That you in kind understand the power of the good that God has put in our hands, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, receive our prayer.
That healing love comes to the wounded souls who have never been praise the Lord.
Lord, receive our prayer.
Realizing our journey is for a lifetime, and that our faith is for the sake of the world, we offer our prayers in the life-giving name of Jesus Christ, the sign of your faithfulness forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated as the altars be prepared.
Thank you.
disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Holy Father, the Bishop of Rome, with John, our Bishop and Father in faith, with all the clergy, the professed religious, the baptized, and your entire people. We pray especially today that you remember your beloved children, our first communicants, their families and friends, and bless them as they come to receive your body and blood as a great sign of their love and your love for them. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your countenance. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, in particular James, the patron of this parish family, and with all the saints and martyrs who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and be praised and glorified through your Son, through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
Jesus, they are receiving of your holy body and blood. Justify our first communicants this day. Always be a source of protection of mind and body and the healing remedy of our spirits. And may it always lead us to the judgment of your love and mercy and bring us to the fullness of life in your kingdom. For behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those fall to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof.
We ask this for our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is arranged with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
And you're going to get away with that now? Each weekend until August 16th, we will be celebrating First Holy Communion on Sundays at 11:30 and 1 p.m. Please keep our First Holy Communicants, their families, and catechists in prayer so that they may grow ever more deeply in love with Jesus in the Eucharist. Starting on Sunday, August 23rd, we will begin having the 8 a.m. Sunday Mass, along with the Saturday 5 p.m. and Sunday 9:30 a.m. The 11:30 Mass is still to be determined as to when the celebration will start again. The Saturday 8 a.m. Mass will begin on Saturday, September 5th.
Lord,